Papa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pius. What a spirit.
Amen.
Aya, kuja hapa Pius. Umesikia Pius amelalamika mpei makofi. Anasema makofi natoka tu hapa mbele. Kwa nini hakutakiwi kupigia Pius makofi? Kuanzia leo, mkiambiwa praise God na Pius mnasema amen. Amen. Sisi sawa. Now turn to your neighbor, tell them, give honor.
Give honor.
Where God has honored.
Where God has honored.
Tell somebody, if you don't honor others,
you will never be honored.
Tell somebody, if you don't value others,
if you don't value others,
ministry. Tell them, if you don't value others' ministry,
if you don't value others' ministry,
your ministry will never be honored.
Your ministry will never be honored.
Is that good?
Yes.
Bwana asifiwe. Sasa mwambie
Bwana. Bwana asifiwe.
Haya, pigeni Yesu makofi sasa. Okay, Bwana asifiwe. Now, I want to take the next in this service. But before we go very high, because we are going to cruise at a very high tonight. Today is 50,000 feet level.
Lakini kabla tuweze kupaa masafa ya juu, manake leo tunaenda katika masafa ya juu zaidi.
I want to you to welcome your neighbor on my behalf.
Ningependa ukaribishe jirani yako kwa niaba yangu.
Just shake their hands.
Kisa mkono.
Give them a smile. Tell them, neighbor, I'm happy you are my neighbor today. Tell them, I hope you had a good week. Tell them, it doesn't matter what you are going through. Tell them, God is here for you and for me. Tell them, this day is the day of a turnaround in my life. In Jesus' name. Tell them you are smart. I told you to speak to your neighbor. Now you're going to have said to your neighbor, hey, and I come and have your this is not a routine kind of it is ministry, personal, person to person. Just like we would lay the hand of your neighbor on a person and pray for them. This is what we are calling personal ministry. Amen. Once again, touch your neighbor. Tell them, it doesn't matter what you are going through.
It doesn't matter what you are going through.
God is on your side.
God is on your side.
And he is here for you today. Open up your spirit.
Open up.
And receive everything that God has for you. Now tell them, you are smart.
You are smart.
But I am smarter than you. Amen. And give a shout of celebration to the Lord. Okay, are we ready?
Yeah, Daddy.
Now before we get into what I feel the Lord saying, I want us to do a corporate prayer. Give me this scripture. Jeremiah chapter 8 verse 22.
Jeremiah 8 verse 22.
Give me that scripture very fast. Hallelujah. Okay, everybody read with me. 1, 2, 3. Is there
no harm
in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is there no healing for the wound of my people? Everybody read again. 1, 2, 3. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is there no healing
for the wound
of my people? Now listen.
Excuse.
Was one of the most treasured places in the land of
Canaan.
And this is where after Joshua conquered half tribe of Manasseh and the other two tribes, they settled there. In this land called Gilead,
Gilead,
that they used to be very famous for the production And yet they could heal so many diseases. There used to be a certain kind of man who used to boil some roots, and people would come from Kenya, wherever, to go and drink those that concoction. Of course, I don't have testimony for it that it was what, because it never continued. So I think it was fake. It was a move of a demon kind of a thing. But this bomb that was found in Gilea. It used to heal every disease. In fact, the people came from even other countries. And it was not from a time, long time ago. Genesis 37:25, everybody read with me, 1, 2, 3. All his sons and daughters came to comfort him, but he refused to be comforted. He said, in mourning will I go down to the grave.
To my son. So
no, which one are we reading? I say 25.
25.
Which one are we reading now? Genesis 37:25. Genesis 37:25. Please, Israel, take control of that thing. As they, everybody, read with you. As they sat down to eat their meal, they looked up and saw a caravan of Ishmaelites coming from
Gilead.
Their camels were loaded with spices, balm, and myrrh, and they were on their way to take them to the town. People used to come. You see this, the Ishmaelites, caravans, they were coming from Gilead. Are you there?
Yes.
Genesis, is that 46:11?
Yes.
Okay, then I'm misquoted. But it is recorded that among the people who came from the Far East, Gilead was their center, both for business and also a place for medicine, medication. How many are here today? How many are here? How many are here? How many are here? How many are here?
Hallelujah.
The house of God,
nyumba ya Bwana,
today,
leo,
is the land of Gilead.
The inchi ya Gilead.
And it, when we gather together,
na tunapokutana pamoja,
God releases the balm.
Mungu anaachilia ule uponyaji.
That balm is a medicine.
Hiyo balm ni madeni dawa.
When it falls on you,
na hiyo dawa inaposhuka juu yako,
it releases divine health.
Inaachilia uponyaji, afya ya kiungu.
In your mind,
ndani ya mawazo.
In your wounded spirit,
katika roho yako iliyojeruhiwa.
In your marriage,
katika ndoa.
In your finances,
katika fedha.
In your vision,
katika maono yako.
In the work of your
hands, katika kazi ya mikono yako.
Between you and your husband,
kati yako na mume.
You and your parents,
wewe na wazazi.
You and your children,
wewe na watoto.
You and your Yeah.
stable.
And you go unhealed.
Now utoke kwamba haujapona.
You go heartbroken and wounded.
Now utoke hapo kwa umevunjika moyo umeumia.
God is frustrated.
Mungu anavunjwa na nini?
Because he has provided a place.
Manake ametualia mahali.
In Gilead.
Hapo Gilead.
His house.
Nyumba yake.
The gathering of God's people.
Kusanyiko la watu wa Mungu.
And the balm that releases the healing today.
Na mafuta haya uponyaji yanayoachilia uponyaji leo.
It's not a certain kind of a promise.
Sio aina ya mmea fulani.
As they could go to get in Gilead.
Kama vile wangelienda Gileadi kupata.
It is the Holy Spirit.
Ni roho.
You didn't hear me? I say it is the Holy Spirit.
Mesema ni roho.
I say it is the Holy Spirit.
Mesema ni roho.
I say it is the Holy Spirit.
Mesema ni roho mtakatifu.
I say it is the Holy Spirit.
Mesema ni roho mtakatifu.
He is the balm of Gilead.
Yeye ndiye uponyaji wa Gilead.
When he comes upon you,
anapokuja juu yako,
he releases his healing power.
Anaachilia nguvu yake
kwa healing virtue.
Nguvu yake uponyaji
upon your life.
Juu ya maisha yako.
Hebu mbele stand up if you are seated.
Simama kwa
the Holy Spirit is the balm of Gilead.
Yeye ndiye nguvu ya uponyaji ya
Gilead. People would come with the camels to come and take.
Wangekuja na magari ya ngamia kuweza
kupokea. Today we don't need camels.
Leo hatuhitaji
magari. We are already in Gilead.
Tuko Gilead.
We are already in Gilead.
Tuko tayari Gilead.
It reminds me.
Inanikumbusha.
Of the pool.
Ya kidimbwi.
Where the lame, the withered, the sick.
Wagonjwa waliopooza
ulingana
wangekutana,
and the angel of the Lord would tie the water.
Malaika wa Bwana angelitibua maji.
And whoever gets in
here, aliyeingia ndani angepona.
Your hearing is a step between now your faith in God and connecting with the Holy Spirit.
Upanya.
Right now
wako huko sasa kati yako wewe hapa kuamini Bwana na kuunganika na Roho.
And he is here to touch.
Na yuko hapa kukugusa.
But the question is, how desperate are you for
him?
Dear Holy Spirit,
I thirst for you. I hunger for you.
I acknowledge you
as my healer,
as my God,
as my teacher,
as my uplifter.
You carry my burdens.
You
heal my broken heart.
Holy Spirit.
You are the balm of Gilead. Come upon me now.
With your curative values.
With your life-changing spirit.
With your
spiritual manifestations.
With your spiritual
Kila mtu nisikize. I'm going to tell you something.
Naenda kuambia kitu.
If it does not change your prayer life,
kama lile jambo halitabadilisha maisha yako ya maombi,
something is wrong with you.
Kuna kitu basi kasoro ndani yako.
And you must cry to God and ask him, show me what is wrong with me.
Na ni lazima mlilie Bwana, mwambie Bwana nionyeshe shida iko wapi.
It is recorded in the Bible.
Imenakiliwa katika Biblia.
In Gethsemane.
Katika Gethsemane.
Jesus prayed.
Yesu akaomba.
And he sweated.
Na akatoa jasho.
The sweat.
Jasho.
Of what?
Love.
I'm asking you. The sweat of what?
Love.
The sweat of what?
Love.
Why did Jesus sweat blood in Gethsemane?
Kwa nini Yesu akatoa jasho ya damu Gethsemane?
Can I give you the answer?
Nikupe jibu.
Are you ready for the answer?
Kwa tayari kwa jibu.
How many are ready for the answer?
Wangapi kwa tayari kwa jibu?
Now this is the answer.
Hili ndilo jibu.
Jesus sweated blood in Gethsemane because the water had gotten finished in his body and he could no longer sweat water. He could only sweat blood.
Yesu aliweza kutoa jasho la damu, manake jasho lote lilikuwa limeisha, hangetoa maji tena ila tu damu.
If you don't teach yourself to pray violently until you sweat.
I know, Lord, you will bless me. Lord, I come to you.
Inakuja kwa
hauliwa ulipo mtakatifu.
Religious prayers will never change your life.
Maombi ya kidini hayatabadilisha maisha yako.
We need violent people in prayer.
Tunahitaji watu wenye kutumia nguvu katika
maombi. Who will bombard heaven?
Watu ambao watapiga mabomu mbinguni.
Until heaven cannot remain silent. If you learn to pray until you sweat,
ukijifundisha kuomba mpaka unatoa jasho,
then you will eat the sweat of your prayers.
Basi hapo utakula jasho la maombi yako.
Yeah. If you will not eat the sweat of your prayers,
kama utakula jasho la maombi yako,
then you will eat from the sweat of kupiga mawe, kokoto na kubeba mkokoteni. Wanasema wanabani calorie. Wanabani nini?
Calorie.
Ukija ishindwe. Mwambie ugwana na umwili kanisani hauna nafasi. Hallelujah. How many are desperate for the healing of the lamb of Gilead? Are you sure you are desperate?
Yes.
Can you make another prayer?
Yes.
This is the last one. Lift up your voice. Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
And by the blood of Jesus.
By the blood of Jesus.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
I acknowledge.
You are the balm of Gilead.
Come upon me now.
inasimama kwenye uwepo wake leo.
Thou Lord Jesus Christ.
Ewe Bwana Yesu Kristo.
The balm of Gilead.
The balm of Gilead.
Thou Holy Spirit.
Wewe Roho Mtakatifu.
The balm of Gilead.
Uponyaji wa Gilead.
Heal the wounds of your people today.
Ponya majeraha ya watu wako leo.
Heal the broken hearted.
Ponya mioyo yao iliyovunjika leo.
Heal their marriages today.
Ponya ndoa zao leo.
Heal their finances today.
Ponya fedha zao leo.
Heal their businesses. Heal their children. Heal our lives.
Ponya
majeraha yao. Ponya
majeraha. Ponya majeraha. Ponya majeraha.
We trust you. We depend on you. Hallelujah. Sipa toko.
He is healing that family.
Anaponya hiyo familia.
Forgive your husband.
Samihe mume wako.
And he is going to be the best blessing you will never know.
Na atakuwa baraka ile ya ajabu ambayo hujawahi kujua.
Somebody is frustrated because of their children.
Unajua amevunjika moyo kwa sababu ya watoto wake.
As a matter of fact, you are a single mother.
Wewe ni mama mmoja single.
You have 3 children.
Na watoto watatu.
And your children have not been very encouraging to you.
Na watoto wako hawajakuwa wa kutia moyo sana.
You are so heartbroken.
Umevunjika moyo.
The Lord is healing him.
Mungu anakuponya.
And he is healing your children.
Na anaponya watoto
wherever they are.
Popote walipo.
God is putting spirit in them.
Mungu anaweka roho wake ndani yao.
They will honor you as their mother.
Watakuheshimu kama mama yao.
And they will also receive you as their father.
Watakupokea pia kama baba yao.
Receive your healing.
Pokea uponyaji.
Receive your healing right now.
Pokea uponyaji sasa.
Receive your healing.
Pokea uponyaji wako.
You have closed your business just the last 1 week.
Umefunga biashara yako wiki moja imepita.
It was not a big business. Just a very simple business.
What to do?
But at least it was giving you food.
Lakini ilikuwa inakupatia mkate chakula.
In fact, you are thinking of relocating from where you are. Because you are not even able to pay the rent again for your house.
Manake hauwezi kulipa hata kodi ya nyumba.
As a matter of fact,
ukweli,
you are just doing small business, selling some sukumas and some other stuff.
Unauza sasa sukuma wiki na vitu zingine.
But it has not been possible to maintain the business, so you have decided to close it.
Lakini ijakuwa hayakuwezekana kuendelea na biashara na hapa sasa kuifunga.
I hear the Lord saying he is going not only to restore you in that place, but from this point in time, your business will start to grow.
Nasikia Bwana akisema atakurejesha kwa biashara ile, sio kwamba tukurejesha lakini itaanza kunawili.
Because he has given you a new beginning.
Manake amekupatia mwanzo mpya.
And he says, do not despise the day of your beginning.
Anasema usidharau siku za mwanzo mdogo.
Who is that lady by the name?
What a mama ni nani?
You are in that business, that's more business.
Wewe ya sauti kwa hiyo biashara ya soko.
Give the other one.
Kitu kama ni wewe yuwa mkono wako.
I have a miracle for you.
Kuna muujiza.
Where is that lady?
Kwa hapi uyo dada.
Lift up your head.
Na mkuja dada.
That person in that small business which you have crossed. Wewe ya sell some skuma and whatever. Don't be ashamed. You are here in your presence, in the presence of God. Lift up your hand. Where is that? Okay, you'll just see me after this. I have your miracle. Father, we thank you.
Baba, tunakushukuru.
For this meeting,
mkutano huu,
do great things in our midst.
Fanya makuu kati yetu.
As we meet upon you,
tunapokungoja.
For surely,
kwa hakika,
there is the balm of Gilead.
Kuna tabibu ya Gilead.
You are the balm.
Wewe ndiye tabibu ya dunia.
We give you praise and honor.
Tunakupa sifa na heshima.
We give you adoration and thanksgiving.
Tunakuabudu na shukrani.
Thou Holy Spirit.
Ewe Roho Mtakatifu.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Stand up in His presence. Takatifu, takatifu. Takuita takatifu, Wewe Yesu, Wewe takatifu, takatifu, takatifu.
in your presence, Lord, may he give you a new glory that will usher in the